next one is not quite as hot, and this one's becoming more and more popular, especially around here, and that's the white chicken chili. Now, the first thing you want to do, of course, is go ahead and pre-cook you some chicken, which I already done. Okay. All right. Then you're going to take some more of the garlic. Once again, I'm just using the pre-mince. It works just as fine. Put that down in there. Let's see. Oh, there's some new oil. There we go. Okay, now we're going to need a medium onion. Now, a lot of these dishes, you'll see that I'm using a white onion. White onions tend to be a little bit stronger in flavor, which tends to stand out more in chili recipes. If you want, if you don't like such strong onion, go ahead and use a yellow onion. Although I wouldn't highly recommend a sweet onion because it kind of throws the flavor off. Okay. Cut this up about the same size as before. Basically, you're just wanting to brown the onions a little bit. There we go. Okay, now you're going to take a red bell pepper. Now you're going to want to cut these fairly thick, a little bit thicker than you did with the onions. Go ahead and pull out the seeds there. And if there's any of that white part there, go ahead and cut it out. That over there. About half an inch cube there. Stir it up a little bit. Just throw those in on top of the onions. Give it another couple minutes. It doesn't have to be completely softened, because the longer you cook it down in the liquids, it'll start softening up the peppers more. It's just enough there to kind of sear them just a little bit with the onions there. Okay. You'll need some chicken broth. Always pour just a little bit in first, kind of glaze the pan. Go ahead and get everything off the pan there, just stir it all in. And then go ahead and start pouring in the rest you need. Okay. And this is another one that, after you, if you don't want to saute the vegetables, if you just want to throw everything into the crock pot, that'd be just as fine too. Just let it slowly cook throughout the day, and it'd be just as fine. You will tell a slight difference in the flavor, because anybody's had just the seared onions or the sauteed onions, it brings out a certain sweetness to it. And so that's why, if you use a crock pot, I prefer to go ahead and saute these in a pan and then throw them into the crock pot and let the rest cook if you want to. And this is one of those you don't, it doesn't really matter as much as if you cook it 6 hours as opposed to 2 hours. It's still going to have a really good flavor within that first 2 hours, and like with this meat here. For one thing, the chicken, it's smaller, it's already, you know, pulled apart and shredded, so it absorbs it, you know, fairly quick. Mm-hmm. And just let it cook that way, it'd be just as fine. But if you just want to leave something just sitting on the side and not have to worry about it, you can go ahead and cook a little bit slower and it'd be just as fine. Okay, now we're going to need some white beans. Now you can use navy beans, you can use northern beans. You know, your preference, it's fine either way. But keep the juice in with them as you throw them in there. And then whole peeled tomatoes. Now those you do want to drain. I'm going to stir the beans up a little bit. Okay. Go ahead and add the chicken in there. Okay. Then you want to just bring your chilies and your seasonings. Got our oregano and our cumin, chili. Now you notice we don't have nearly the amount of chili in this recipe as we do the others. For one thing, this is a white chili, but you do want to have the flavor incorporated in there of a regular chili. Okay. Stir that all in. And just let that cook. Basically want to let it simmer down enough to where the sauce starts thickening up a little bit. That's what I was saying, it doesn't have to cook all day if you don't want it to, but you do want to at least get it to where it's not so much a soup as it is a stew. So just let it cook down enough to where it thickens up. It will draw out from the beans and everything to help thicken up there. Okay. Put a lid on that. Set that off the side. Oops. Right. And this is one of those that's got a rich, you know, flavor as well as an aroma, and it is very colorful as well. Okay. There we go.